Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you types of computer networks. Like you can have PAN, personal area network, LAN, local area network, MAN, metropolitan area network, CAN, campus area network, or WAN, wide area network. So here, what I'll do is I'll explain you each and every network along with practical examples. That will give you more clarity regarding how all those computer networks are established over entire globe. So first of all, I'll explain you all these computer networks based on their range and based on the technologies. So here, when it comes to wide area network, then that is established above the range of 50 kilometer. And to establish this network, we need to have technologies based on leased line and dial-up. This wide area network that has been implemented over the range of countries. When it comes to metropolitan area network, then that is having range from 5 to 50 kilometer. That has been implemented over cities. Like Mumbai city is having metropolitan area network. It could be implemented over Ahmedabad, Surat, right? So that is how, based on city size, this network is been implemented. To implement that, technologies used are ATM, means asynchronous transfer machine, FDDI means fiber distributed data interfaces, CDDI means copper distributed data interfaces. So based on these technologies, metropolitan area network over the range of 5 to 50 kilometer over cities can be implemented, right? When it comes to CAN, then that is campus area network. Its range varies from 1 to 5 kilometer, and that could be implemented using Ethernet technology. Campus area network, that could be implemented over the campuses. Like MIT of USA is having their own campus in which there can be CAN. Like here in India, we are having various IITs that is also having campus area network that is having size of 1 to 5 kilometer range, right? This CAN can be also implemented over some corporate offices like Microsoft, like TCS. They are having huge size of campuses, right? In that also we can have campus area network, and to implement that we need to have Ethernet technology. As if you want to implement local area network that is having distance up to 2 kilometer, that could be implemented using Wi-Fi and Ethernet technologies. And personal area network that is having range up to 100 meter, and that we can implement by Bluetooth and Zigbee technology, right? So based on the distance, based on the technologies, various computer networks are implemented around the globe. Now I'll explain you all these types of computer network along with various parameters. So that will give you more clarity regarding how exactly these computer networks have been established. So here, let me explain you first of all full form of all these network. PAN means personal area network, LAN means local area network, CAN means campus area network, MAN means metropolitan area network, and WAN means wide area network. And I have already told you the range in terms of distance with all these network. Like personal area network is having range from 1 to 100 meter. Local area network that is having range up to 2 kilometer. Campus area network is having range from 1 to 5 kilometer. Metropolitan area network is having range from 5 to 50 kilometer. And above 50 kilometer, we can have wide area network. Here, when it comes to transmission speed, then that is depending on how range is there. Like personal area network that is having short range, that's why you can say transmission speed that will be very high over here. With local area network also transmission speed will be very high. With campus area network, transmission speed that will decrease compared to local area network. And with metropolitan area network, transmission speed will be average, and with wide area network, it will be low. I have seen students are saying like, sir, with wide area network, we already access network with very high speed. And you are saying like transmission speed is low. But my dear students, this transmission speed that is based on how we occupy the bandwidth of given link. If your length of link that is short, then you can occupy complete bandwidth. So I am talking about highest capacity of transmission speed. So highest capacity of transmission speed, obviously that will be highest over here with personal area network. Why? The reason is range is very short. With local area network, it will be even more compared to all these networks. And as you increase the distance, transmission speed that will decrease. Obviously, with wide area network, we have transmission speed up to Gbps. But because of length of link, you can say it is a bit lower compared to the technologies which is having short range. Right. Now, I need to go out of the screen. The reason is I want to explain you a few more parameters. So, here, when it comes to area, then based on the distance, you can say personal area network could be established within the room. Local area network that could be there inside the building and offices. In my office also, I'm having my own local area network. Campus area network that could be established within the universities. Like I have already given examples, like you can have campus area network in MIT of USA. With IITs of India also, we are having campus area network. With corporate offices like Microsoft, TCS are also having campus area network as they are having huge campus, right? Metropolitan area network that could be established over the cities. Like we can have that in Mumbai city, in Ahmedabad, in New York, in Surat. We can have metropolitan area network, right? Wide area network that could be established over the region of countries. So based on range only, that has been defined over here. Here, when it comes to technology, then we can establish personal area network using Bluetooth and Zigbee technology. Here, local area network that could be established by Wi-Fi and Ethernet. In my office, I'm having local area network with the usage of Wi-Fi as well as Ethernet. In campus area network, we can have that by Ethernet technology. Metropolitan area network could be established using ATM, asynchronous transfer machine, FDDI, fiber distributed data interface, CDDI, copper distributed data interface, and wide area network that is been established by the technologies based on leased line and dial-up. When it comes to ownership, then here personal area network ownership is private. Local area network ownership is also private. My company's ownership is belongs to me, right? Based on Wi-Fi and Ethernet, so that ownership is private. Campus area network, that ownership belongs to those universities and corporate office. So you can say that is also private. Metropolitan area network, that ownership that may be private or public, that depends which company is providing that. You can say that company is owning that ownership, right? And here, when it comes to wide area network, then you can say it is also having ownership which is public or private, right? So based on which company is owning that network, based on that you can say it is public or private. When it comes to maintenance, then maintenance is very easy with personal area network. Why? The reason is range is very limited. Number of nodes are also limited. So maintenance will be very easy. And as you increase the distance, maintenance cost that will increase. Like local area network will be having easier maintenance compared to CAN. CAN is having moderate maintenance, and as you increase the distance, MAN is having difficult maintenance and WAN is having very difficult maintenance, right? Here, when it comes to error rate, that is also depending on range. So for short range, you can say error rate will be very less, right? And as you increase the distance, your error rate that will increase. Like with local area network, error rate will be low. With campus area network, it will be moderate. Error rate will be high for metropolitan area network. And it is very high with wide area network. Why? The reason is, as you increase the distance, error rate over the channel will increase, right? And cost is also based on size of network. So cost will be very low with personal area network, it is low with local area network, it is moderate with campus area network, it is high with metropolitan, and it is very high with wide area network. So that is how basic parameters are there, right? So I think now you are having fair enough idea about how all those computer networks that has been established over the globe. So based on the requirement, we can implement all these networks along with the technologies which I have mentioned over here in this video. Still, if anything that you like to share it with me, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.